Hi friends, welcome to our Children's Health YouTube channel. Today we'll see about areas of similar triangles theorem, which will come under triangles chapter of SSLC. Areas of similar triangles theorem 2.6. What exactly this theorem says? The ratio of the areas of two similar triangles is equal to the square of the ratio of the corresponding sides. We'll just see numerically how we can represent this. See, now we have considered two triangles ABC and ABC and PQR triangles. For this we have drawn perpendicular, that is PN and AM. What this theorem says, ratio of areas of two similar triangles. Ratio of two similar triangles means area of ABC, then area of PQR, that is this one, is equal to square of the ratio of the corresponding sides. Square of the corresponding sides, that is in triangle ABC we have side AB, BC and AC. Here we have considered AB, divided by corresponding side of other triangle, that is PQ. So AB by PQ square, this is also equal to their side BC, that is this one, divided by QR whole square. That is also equal to CA divided by RP whole square. So basically in today's session we need to prove this. See, for finding the areas of the two triangles, we draw altitude AM and PN of the triangles. That is, in order to find the areas of these two triangles, that is ABC and PQR, we need perpendicular, that is altitude of this triangle. Why this we need basically? Basically, what areas of triangle, what is the formula for area of triangle? That is half into base into height. Here we know the base, that is BC. In this triangle base is QR. So height is nothing but the altitude that we need to draw a line perpendicular to the base, and it has to pass through the third point of the triangle, that is altitude or height. So now area of ABC, area of ABC is equal to half into base is nothing but BC over here in this triangle, and height is nothing but AM, BC into AM. Then we will take area of PQR. Why do we need to take only area of PQR? Why can't we take area of PQN or PN or something? Because ultimately we need to prove area of ABC and area of PQR. That's why we are finding over here area of ABC and area of PQR. Now, as per the theorem statement, we will divide this area of ABC by PQR. So we will be left out with BC by QR into AM by PN. So here if you compare this equation with whatever that we need to prove, in this BC by QR it is already there, but AM by PN it is not there. So our next step is we need to prove AM by PN is equal to BC by QR, so that we are going to get one more BC by QR. So if you multiply BC into BC is equal to BC square, QR into QR is QR square. So now our aim is to find AM by PN is equal to BC by QR. So now we need to prove AM divided by PN is equal to BC by QR. So for that we need to consider another two triangles which contains AM and PN. So let us take triangle ABM and triangle PQ and N. In this triangle ABM and PQN, we can say angle B is equal to angle Q, because as these two triangles are similar, angle B is equal to angle Q, angle A is equal to angle P, angle C is equal to angle R as per the Thiele's theorem. So next, obviously angle M is equal to angle N, because this is right angle triangle, means we have drawn perpendicular line to base. So angle M is equal to angle N. So by this we can say, when angle B is equal to angle Q, angle M is equal to angle N, obviously this angle, that is NPQ angle, is equal to MAB. So with this we can say triangle ABM is similar to triangle PQN. So what our Thiele's theorem says, if two triangles are similar, their corresponding sides are also equal. This we can write like, now we can write AM by PN, that is AM divided by PN is equal to AB by PQ. This AB by PQ, corresponding sides are equal. So this we will call it as equation 2. Then comes to triangle ABC and triangle PQ are similar. This we have already known from the equation itself, that is two similar triangles. By this we can write same thing as I explained, what Thiele's theorem says, if two triangles are similar, their corresponding sides also, ratio of their corresponding sides also equal, that is AB by PQ, this is AB divided by PQ is equal to BC divided by QR, then CA divided by RP. This is equation number 3. Therefore, from 1 and 2, what is 1 says, area of ABC by area of PQR, that is this one, is equal to BC by QR into AM by PN. BC by QR we have taken it out as it is. In place of AM by PN, we have written AB by PQ. This is from equation 2. Here we have AM by PN is equal to AB by PQ. This we have substituted over here. In place of AM by PN, we have substituted AB by PQ. This is from equation 1 and equation 2. Then comes to BC by QR, we will just written as it is. AB by PQ will replace with BC by QR. How? From equation 3. From equation 3, we can see over here, AB by PQ is also equal to BC by QR. So if we further simplify this one, we can write it as BC by QR whole square. So area of ABC divided by area of PQR is equal to BC by QR whole square. Similarly for other two sides. Friends, thank you for watching. If you have any doubt, please write it in your comments column. We'll just get back to you. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to our channel for more videos.